Hi friends, this is Leela. Welcome to my channel Leela Web Dev. In the previous video, we have seen how the configuration file will look like and what are the rules that are present in the configuration file. Now, in this video, what we will try to do is we will try to add some of the rules that we will bring it that we will get it from the internet or from the ESLint website documentation, and we will try to add some of our rules in this configuration file, and we will try to check. So, what are the rules we want to add it. By checking the code, and we'll try to add it. Now, first you need to understand is ESLint recommended. So, what is this ESLint recommended? So, ESLint recommended is nothing but what I can say is some of the rules that are recommended rules will be there for a JavaScript file or any code to work. So, in order to make it as a good code or we as a good developers, so we need to implement some recommended rules. So, these recommended rules are automatically will be implemented. And this extends what it will try to do is it will extend this it will try to implement these recommended rules along with the here it is one, okay, along with the rules that what we have mentioned. Okay, now let's try to see what are the rules that are recommended that are added here. If you try to check in the documentation, if I go to this ESLint documentation, okay, so let's try to open the ESLint documentation. This is the documentation. If you want to know what are the rules that are present in the ESLint means, you can go to the user guide. And we have seen the configuring of the ESLint. So how we have to configure. Now let's try to see another one that is nothing but rules. Okay. So this is the rules. Now here, if you try to see, these are all the, what we can say, these are all the rules that are available that we can write it in the configuration file. So these are all rules. So now here you'll be able to see some of the possible errors. So what is this possible errors is? Nothing but what I can say is, if you don't implement these things in your code means, so it may lead to possible errors. Okay, so for this reason, so this may lead to possible errors. Now here, if you try to see here, best practices. Okay, so if you implement these things means, so it will be best practice. Okay, so now if you don't implement these all rules means, okay, fine, the code will work without any problem. The code will work. But implementing these rules will be a best practice. And if you are implementing this one means, so you can avoid the possible errors. If you are not implementing means, the code may run into a possible errors, it is trying to say. And here, if you try to see, for every rule, there is a tick mark. Okay. Some of the rules, there is no tick mark. So these tick marks are nothing but what we can say is, these are all recommended rules. Recommended rules means, so we will be mentioning this ES extends ESLint recommended, right? So these all the things are automatically mentioned in that recommended rules. So if you are extending this ESLint recommended means, so you are implementing nothing but you are implementing all the rules that are having the tick mark. Okay. So which are not having the tick mark means, you, if you want to implement means, you can write it in your configuration file. So that is the ESLint recommended thing. Okay. You need to understand. And now what you need to do is, so for example, here is my code. Let's assume that here is my code. Now here you are able to see that. So this function is returning is returning a value only a particular scenario, that is, if a number is positive only, it is returning true. So that means if the number is negative means it is not returning anything. So this is a bad code. So this leads to some possible errors. Why? Because so whoever using this check positive method means they are expecting some return value. But here if the number is positive only, it is returning the value. If number is positive, it is returning nothing. So now here we need to implement a ESLint rules thing. That means if you are returning anything means, so the function must return something. Okay, in any scenario. So what you can do, so now let's try to see the rules. So if you try to see the rule, there is one rule, something like consistent return. Consistent return. Okay, this the name itself is telling that consistent return. So you need to return in any scenarios. So if you try to take this consistent return, okay, and if you go to the ESLintRC.json file, and you need to mention it here in the rules. So if I mention it consistent return, and here if I mention it as, so now I already told you, right? So there will be three options: error, off, and warn. Error means you are mentioning that it is a must and should we need to implement. Warn means you are showing it as a warning, so nothing, so the code will not stop or anything, so no, you can go it. Off means it will not show any errors. So right now I want to show it as an error, so I will take it as an error thing. Okay, so now first one we have mentioned it as error. Now let's try to execute the file. So if I try to execute the file, let's go here and write ESLint.js. Now let's try to see. Now here we are able to see the error. expected to return a value at the end of the function check positive. So this error is coming from the rule consistent return, and it is telling the line number and the type of the error. It is saying it is an error. Now what we need to do? So let's go to the main.js file, and here I can write something like return false. So now we are returning something. So check positive will return value at any scenarios. Now here I can go, and if I try to run the ESLint.js file, now successfully. So it is trying to execute the successfully. Now, for example, see here I have written console.log. Okay, let's assume that console.log. Okay, Leela web dev. I am mentioning Leela web dev. And if I try to run the ESLint.js, okay, if I try to run this ESLint.js, now let's try to see, we are getting an error that, okay, string must be used single quote. So see, these type of rules, we are having a consistent thing. So why? Because we are having these type of things we need to implement is, so if you are working with a team of something like 10 members or 100 members, if you are working, so these type of consistent things will be maintained by all the team members. For example, some people may be mentioning the strings in double quotes, some people may be mentioning in the single quotes. Now you will be able to see that, what I can say, all the people will mention the string in a single quote only. So you'll be having a consistent, and also the indentation. So spacing between the each line. So these all spacing will be there, and the line feed also, line breaks also. They all the things will be maintained consistently by all the team members. Okay. So now if I try to run this ESLint.js, now it's perfect. So nothing, no errors is there. But for here, the problem is, now here I am using the console.log. So now you will be able to think that console.log, so some of the browsers will not support, old browsers will not support. This console.log is something like a tricky thing. So I don't want to use the console.log in my project. So I don't want to allow all the team members, all the developers also to use the console.log. So then wherever the UP developer, sometimes for debugging or purpose or anything, so they'll be using the console.log. So after debugging and all those things, so when they are running the ESLint, I want them to remove this console.logs. So how can I do this one? So now you can go to here the rules. So if I go to the user guide, and if I go to the rules here, now here if you try to go here, you'll be able to see that no console. Okay, no console. So no console will take options. So what is the options it is taking? Allow or not, it will try to take. Okay. So allow means, so warn, error or anything. So now what I can do here I will take this no console, okay, in the rules, and I will try to add it in the eslint.rc.json file. Here I will try to add it no console. I want to show it as an error. Your wish. You want to show it as an error or you want to show it as a warning? Your wish. So now if I try to see here eslint.js file. So now if I try to run this one, so what will happen? Here we are able to see two errors. So that means we are using two console statements. So where we are using these two console statements? Yeah, first one is here, and another one is, yeah, for the check positive we are using. So let's remove these console.logs so that all the console.logs has been removed. Now let's try to run the ES. So for example, let's clear it and ESLint.js file. So ESLint.js, if I try to run, see, now everything is done. So now we have successfully added the two rules, some of the two rules, nothing but what I can say, consistent return. That means, so a function should has to return in any scenarios, and also the console error. So that means console error means we should not use the console thing in our project. Okay, hope you understood about this one. So all the time, so now what I can say is, we can run this ESLint code as an npm script also. So how we can run this npm script means, for example, we have a package.json file, and here we are having the scripts, right? So normally what I will try to do is, so I will have a lint here. Okay, so I will maintain the lint here. So here I can write something like npm, okay, sorry, ESLint space JS. Okay, so I can run like this. So if you want to fix it, means, so you can use something like lint-fix, and here I can get something like ESLint.js file --fix. Okay, so these are the two things. Now what I will try to do here, let's go here and I will try to run npm run lint. So if I try to run npm run lint, means automatically it will try to run that ESLint file, ESLint.js. So here it is trying to run the ESLint.js. Now if we let it run ESLint.js, Now we are able to see nothing is there, nothing is there. Now for example, let's try to add some errors. Now what I can do here, let's try to add console. Okay, so whether it will be automatically fixed or not. Okay, so I have added some rules. Now let's try to run it, npm run lint. Let's try to see whether the errors are coming or not. So it is running ESLint.js. Okay, we got errors. So that indentation is required, it seems, but found 3, it seems. I don't know. So yeah, we have written 3. Okay, fine. So it should be in line with the if thing. So it has become one space backwards it became. Okay, it came. Okay, fine. Unexpected console statement. These are all things. So 2 errors can be automatically fixed, it seems. So okay, fine. Let's try to run npm lint hyphen fix. Or otherwise, let me clear it out. Okay, I clear it out. Npm run lint hyphen fix. I am fixing. So let's try to see how, what are the things that can be fixed. Now see, it is fixing, it is trying to fix. Now yeah, so 2 of the errors has been fixed, and one thing, console statement is the only one it is not able to fix. Okay, fine. Let's try to see, it is in the second line of the main.js file. Okay, fine. Let's go to the main.js file in the second line. So we can remove this one all. And now what I can do, so now here if you try to see, let's try to run it runs again, but last time npm run lint. Let's try to check whether it will get success or not. So here we are, it is trying to execute. Yeah, it is executed. So now successfully we have added some of the rules that from the ESLint documentation. So we have added the rules and we have executed successfully, we have did it right. Fantastic. So this is how we can, if you want to add some of our rules present in the user guide, you want to add the rules, means you can check the documentation here. So you can see all the rules here, you will be able to see all the type of rules. You can go one by one each rule and you can add it way, whatever the rule you want to add, we can add it. Okay, hope you understood about this one, how to add the rules in the ESLint RC.json file, and also how to add this ESLint command in the npm script also. If you have any doubts or any suggestions, please post the comments below to this video. And if you like this video, please do support me by subscribing to my channel. And also please do follow my Facebook page, Leela Web Dev. So it is provided in the description. Thank you.